Hello everyone. Let us read out today's thought. Start each day with a positive thought and a grateful heart. Once you replace negative thoughts with positive ones, you will start having positive results. Every day is a new beginning. Take a deep breath, smile, and start the day with positive thought. Let us discuss an activity. You can try this at home. Switch off the light in your room at night for some time and then turn it on. Could you see the objects in the room clearly when the light was switched off? Of course, no. The objects in the room are not visible clearly when the lights are switched off. What did you feel when it was turned on again? We could see the object clearly, right? When the switch is turned on. From this activity, one can notice that there is some connection between the sense of vision and light. When we switch off the light at night, the objects in the room cannot be seen, and they can be seen as before when the light is switched on again. Thus, we can see objects when the light coming from these objects enter our eyes. Clear to you all? Actually, children, have you noted down one concept? That when the room is completely dark, no light falls on the object and hence no light enters our eyes. And therefore, there is no sensation of vision. And that is, we cannot see the object. So objects are visible only because of light which is reflected by these objects. When light rays fall on an object, their direction changes and they turn back. And this reflected rays, when they reach to our eyes, the objects are visible. So what is reflection of light? When light rays fall on an object, their direction changes and they turn back. This is called the reflection of light. Let us discuss one more activity. A white paper is kept on a drawing board or on a table. A comb is taken and leaving out some portion in the middle of the comb, rest of the part of the comb is covered with black paper so that light can only pass through the open central portion. This is how the middle portion is kept open and rest of the part of the comb is covered with the black paper. Now light can pass only through the open central portion. Here it is clearly seen. Hold the comb perpendicular to the white paper and then throw torch light on the central portion. Adjust the comb and torch so as to get light rays on the white paper. Now keep the mirror on the path of this ray of light. What will be the observation here? Light rays which fall on the mirror get reflected and travel in a different direction. Light from the torch will pass through the open central portion and these rays will fall on the mirror and they get reflected in various directions. Actually, by allowing light to pass through the central middle portion, we are actually trying to focus a beam of light. Right? So here you can see, beam of light strikes the mirror and it gets reflected in different direction. Here, a laser beam is meant to fall on a plane mirror and the reflected rays are shown in different direction. Means here only a single beam of light is, single ray of light is falling on the mirror and the reflected light is shown. Now let us try to understand the terminologies which are attached, means which are related to this concept. What is incident? What is an incident ray? A ray of light falling on the surface is called an incident ray. The ray which is shown here by blue color is called as incident ray. It is falling on the surface of mirror. What is the reflected ray? The ray of light that leaves the surface at the point of reflection is called as reflected ray. But before that, we have to understand what is the point of incidence. The point at which the incident ray strikes the surface is called as the point of incidence. Now let us understand what is normal. The perpendicular to the surface at the point of incidence is called as normal. Children, see here, this is the point of incidence and the normal means it is a perpendicular to the surface of this point of incidence, and the ray which is reflected back is called as reflected ray. And let us understand now what is angle of incidence and angle of reflection. Angle of incidence means the angle made by incident ray with normal is called as angle of incidence. And angle of reflection, the angle made by reflected ray with normal is called as angle of reflection. Children, have you understood all the terminologies which are related to the reflection of light? See here, incident ray, the ray of light falling on the surface of mirror is called as incident ray. And what is reflected ray? The ray of light that leaves the surface at the point of reflection, it is same as the point of incidence, that is called as reflected ray. Now we are going to see laws of reflection. The rays which are striking at the point of incidence are called as incident rays. The direction of reflected rays is decided by some rules and which are called as laws of reflection. Laws of reflection are stated here. Number one, angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. The incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence means the angle made by incident ray with normal. It is shown by symbol I, and that is angle of incidence. Angle of reflection, the angle made by reflected ray with normal is called as angle of reflection, and it is shown by letter R. Is it clear to you? Angle of incidence means angle made by incident ray with normal, and angle of reflection R means angle made by reflected ray with normal. Angle of incidence I is always equal to angle of reflection R. If angle of incidence is 30 degree, then angle of reflection will be approximately equal to 30 degree. We can have various angles of incidences like 30 degree, 40.5 degree, 50 degree, 60 degree. And if you measure the angle of reflection, then you will come to know that they are approximately equal to angle of incidences. Here it is again clearly shown. All the concepts related to reflection of light. See here, incident ray means the ray which strikes the mirror surface is called as incident ray. Then angle of incidence is shown. Angle made by incident ray with normal. Normal is the perpendicular line which is striking to the horizontal plane mirror at 90 degree. Then angle made by reflected ray with normal is called as angle of reflection. You can see here I is the angle of incidence and angle R is the angle of reflection. Angle I is always equal to angle R. If angle of incidence I is equal to 30 degree, then angle of reflection R will also be equal to 30 degree. Incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence and the reflected ray, they all lie in the same plane. Light rays which fall on the mirror get reflected and travel in different direction. The rays falling on any surface are called incident rays. The point at which an incident ray falls is called as point of incidence. The rays going away from the surface after reflection are called reflected rays. The direction of reflected rays is decided by some rules and which are called as law of reflection. Let us understand this diagram. Line PQ shows the position of mirror. Line PQ shows position of mirror. AO is the incident ray and ray OB is the reflected ray. Perpendicular is drawn at the position of mirror at point O, and this line ON line is called as normal. ON is perpendicular to PQ. Correct? Now see here, ray AO is the incident ray. Point O is the point of incidence. Ray OB is the reflected ray. Line ON is the normal. Angle AON, that is the angle between incident ray and normal, is called as angle of incidence. Angle BON, that is the angle made by reflected ray with normal, is called as angle of reflection, and it is denoted by letter R. Understood clearly? There are three laws of reflection. These are given below. The angle of reflection is equal to angle of incidence. Angle I is equal to angle R. The incident ray, the reflected ray and normal lie in the same plane. The incident ray and the reflected ray are on the opposite sides of normal. See here, incident ray and reflected ray, they lie on the opposite sides of normal. Angle of incidence, if it is 30 degree, then angle of reflection will be also 30 degree.